Today we will be doing revision on module 4, cyber security concepts. So here many catalogs will come. So those are the important things you have to remember in this module. So we will go through those things. So first, before that, we will understand what is cyber security. So you know, cyber security means it refers to security offered through online services. With an increasing amount of people getting connected to internet, the security threats that cause massive harm are increasing day by day. So here what we are going to understand, here we are understanding what is the need of security, what actually security is, what is the need of cyber security, and what are the security problems in the cyber field, and how to implement and maintain security of a cyber field around us. So the meaning of cyber means nothing but it is combining relating information technology, internet and virtual reality. So here the need of security is it is necessary since it helps us in securing data from threats such as data theft or misuse. So in order to provide authentication to our data, this need of security is needed. So what are the major security problems? So one is virus, hacker, malware, Trojan horses, password cracking. So these are some major security problems. So what is virus and worms? You know, virus is nothing but a program that is loaded into your computer without your knowledge and runs against your wishes. So that is nothing but virus. So it can replicate itself. Once you copy those files, it can replicate it by itself. So how we can provide a solution for this? By installing antivirus. So by installing antivirus, we can provide security to our data. So install a security suite that protects the computer against threats such as viruses and worms. So these are some known antiviruses as we are using this regularly, like McAfee, Kaspersky, Avast, Norton, Avaste, QuickHeal. So these are some different known antiviruses. So what is hacker? A hacker is a person who breaks into computers, usually by gaining access to administrative controls. So what this hacker will do? Hackers, what it will do, if a person A and B is, user A and B is communicating means, so he will hack the data from user B. So user A is sending data to user B. So user B will think that he is actually receiving data from user A, but the actual data is modulated and will be sent from some user C. So that is nothing but a hacker. So here types of hacker is, one is white hat hacker, gray hat hacker and black hat hacker. So how to prevent hacking? So it is very impossible to prevent computer hacking, but by using some security controls, by effective security, we can control the hackers by setting strong passwords and by using firewalls, so which help us to prevent the hacking. So malware is nothing but what? Malicious functions. So the word malware comes from the term malicious software. So malware is any software that infects and damages a computer system without the owner's knowledge or permissions. So how to stop this malware? One, by download an anti-malware program. Another, by activate network protection like firewall and antivirus. So Trojan horse. So Trojan horse, it is a dangerous virus. Which are specially comes under when you are sending a mail. So these are also called as email viruses that can duplicate themselves and they can steal information or harm the computer system. These viruses are the most serious threats to computers. So in your system such as Windows, if you are getting this, so your system is affected with Trojan horse. So how to avoid Trojans means by security suits such as Avasta, internet security will prevent you from downloading Trojan virus. So password cracking. So password attacks are attacks by hackers that are able to determine passwords or find passwords to different protected electronic areas and social network suites. So some they can guess the password. So if some may be setting the password based on their family names and daughter name, son name. So this such passwords are easily guessable. So you have to set the password such a way that it should not be guessable by any person. So use always strong password, never use same password for different sites. So cyber security is everyone's responsibility. So this is the cyber security strategy in India. So India stands 10th in the cyber crime in the world. So these are about basic things about cyber security. So actual syllabus will start from here. So here we'll be studying some anti-patterns and catalogs. So these are very important from the exam point of view. So what actually this anti-pattern means? Anti-pattern means nothing but it employs a physiological framework for solving problems. So anti-patterns means it is used to solve the problems whose causes involve habitual mistakes. So anti-patterns require a mind shift from the dispassionate mindsets of mathematics and engineering into the judgmental milieu of enterprise architecture and organization change. Anti-patterns have ancient roots in governance, law enforcement, religion, and public administration. So next topic is system architecture. So there we have discussed about anti-pattern is nothing but it is used to solve the patterns. So some architecture, system architecture we'll be studying. So here the cyber security crisis is a fundamental failure of architecture. Many of the network technology we depend upon really have no effective security whatsoever. The architecture of the internet and the vast majority of deployed software create insignificant opportunity for malicious exploitation. It is worth stating that if infrastructure and software technologies were engineered properly, they would be built to withstand known and manage unknown risk. They should be significantly more secure than current day technologies. So anti-pattern signature based from malware detection versus polymorphic threats. So malware detection means nothing but what? Malicious software means some unauthenticated persons detection. So here malicious signature growth is exploding from 5 new ones per day. So if you compare, if you see in 2000 only 5 new ones malicious were detected. Then if you see in 2007, 1500 per day it is detected. Then in 2000 it is 15,000 per day. So day by day it is increasing. So day by day this malicious signature growth is exploding. So for that reason, malware variability has grown so rapidly that signature-based detection is rapidly becoming obsolete. One interesting online application from virustool.com runs more than 30 antivirus programs on each file they can internet user can submit. So nowadays our systems are getting more affected with antivirus, so we have to download anti-malware functions so that we can avoid such dangerous effects. So here one tool they have mentioned, it is virustotal.com, which has 30 antivirus program on easy file that any internet user can submit. Refactored solution. Next topic is refactored solution, reputational behavior and entropy based malware detection. So here vendors are purchasers. They are developing innovative techniques that can detect 0-day and polymorphic malware. Several promising approaches for the future include Symantec is harnessing a 100 million global customer to identify potential malware signatures. The technique called reputation-based signature, it is able to identify 240 million new malware signatures by comparing binaries across millions of systems for anomalous variations. So FireEye has created a behavioral intrusion detection system. And here an emerging field of research called entropy-based malware detection looks for mathematical similarity to a known malware signature. So these are some topics which they will be asking write a brief note on. refactor solution, write a brief note on reputational theory and entropy based malware detection. So for this you have to explain a few points. In the brief you have to explain about these points. So next topic is document driven certification and accreditation. So this is also it is also an important question they will be asking in short notes. So here when they ask about document driven certification and accreditation, so you have, as you know, documentation means nothing but you have to maintain a documentation for the processes. So here when they ask this question, you have to explain about assessment and authorization. So what is assessment and authorization? That we have to explain. As you know, A&A, that is assessment and authorization, is the process of assuring the information security of systems before they are deployed. Accreditation is an executive approval process that accepts risk discovered during certification. In many organizations, certification is problematic. Although A&A is formalized in government organization, it is also widely practiced in industry. So these are the things you have to mention when they ask to write a brief note on document driven certification and accreditations. Similarly, another short notes they may ask, and that is policy driven security certification do not address the threat. So here you have to explain about CISSP. So what is this CISSP? Is nothing but Certified Information System Security Professional. It is entirely a paper-based qualification. Its security domains are physical security, communication security, and system security. So it is required by US Department of Defense for both management as well as technical security workers. Anecdotally, the presumed goal of this certification is to produce articulate security professional. Many people in the cyber security community view the finding as controversial because their careers, reputations, and credentials are invested in security, compliance, policies, and procedures. Unfortunately, the most professional, it is much easier to turn a highly technical person into a policy person, whereas it is very difficult to turn a policy person into a highly technical one. It is a one-way street. So next is refactored solution security training roadmap. So here one approach for this professional training hands-on skill is science institutes with a handful of other places. So this science institute, it offers master level degree which both requires numerous science certification to achieve. Parentheses indicate where the materials occur, like SANSEC 401, SANSEC 504, 516, 503. So these are the things which are providing by the SANS Institute. So some suggested curriculum at DC3 includes the following. One is Computer Incident Responders course, Network Exploitation Techniques, Network Monitoring course, Advanced Log Analysis, Live Network Investigations. So these are the suggested curriculum at DC3. So these are the things which are included. So the following additional science offered are for Red Team members. So these are the following additional science courses. One is SANSEC 542, which is nothing but a web app pen testing and ethical hacking. Another is SANSEC 617, wireless ethical hacking and pen testing. SANSEC 660, advanced penetration testing. So these are things which are provided by SANS Institute. Next, some of the suggested offensive security curriculum along with the suggested SANS prerequisites. So what are the prerequisites from the SANS Institute? Is one is SANSEC 401, which is the security essential. Another is penetration testing with backtrack, and third one is wireless attacks, and fourth one is cracking the perimeter. So the following is recommended list of specialized skills that should be available on demand in IT security shops. One is network device specialist, where vendor certified is specialist with a deep knowledge debugging and configuring network devices. If you take, for example, routers and firewalls. So as you know, routers are which will help us to route the data packets, and firewalls which is used to authenticate our packets. So next is operating system security specialist, where specialist in configuring and hardwaring the security of each operating system in your environment. So example, you can, as you know, Red Hat, Novell, EI, digital security and other operating system. Database security specialist. Next one is database security specialist. Here, specialist in configuring the security of specific database types in your environment. For example, as you know, Oracle, Sybase, application security, Wellhouse, and other database specialists. So these are some recommended specialized skills. So next is a system forensic specialist. So here specialist in-depth analysis of system, creating chains of evidence and other forensic investigation techniques. So here training from Defense Cyber Crime Center, Science Institute, Guidance Software, Access Data and other forensic specialists. So next one is reverse engineering malware specialist. One is security researcher who captures malware and analyzes its characters with the goal of permanent eradication from your networks. So application, educations and training from Science Institute, Invisible Things Lab, Black Hat courses and other security. So these are the things, these are the specialized things from the Science Institute.